Hypocrites is a sign that we typically use. A lot of religious people were doing that, but behind their religion, your eyes really stemming very heavily. Sounds because I would feel like people, large things that I need to confess ahead of and other people. But the thing too, we are sinners. I need to ask God every single day to help me and forgive me of my sins. Do you go to God every day and ask Him to help you with your sins? Because they're all sins. So, Jesus and myself and I, you know, well, he's been very polite to the people that were there with him. A lot of them were religious leaders, and they were pretending to be holy when they really weren't. And so in the first chapter, there are prostitutes and tax collectors. And Jesus said they are going to heaven before you, and not the religious leaders. And the prophet died of it. We're all a sinner, and we're all a saint. There's some people saying they're not. It's really true. It's the truth. It's the solution for the truth. And it says, hypocrisy is one of the most insidious sins within the church. Because when we take the name of Christ, when we declare ourselves to be Christians, the wrong is suddenly getting us. So any of our people that can, and then go into their boyfriend or girlfriend or whatever it is, that they go to church. It's a view of others as it is. And you say, you are a Christian, and you know that your boyfriend or your girlfriend is sin. And then you go to church, but then outside of church, they go and hang out with people and they talk about their advantage and, of course, joking and all of that. It's an example of us. Doing the best, trying to keep doing that stuff. It says, you can't be like the boss in the project was the ignorant of some. And when Will, from one does the rest of them, he's in there, they come to us, there's some other type of people came to me. I see the situation. And he authority when you do these things, he told you that's authority. You run us a temple and you get in there to preach. And a true person, I'll live, not a priest, not a Catholic, but different, not a Catholic. So, he was a Lutheran, a Pharisee. So, the group of people from England, the elders, the leaders, temple, so, if she met him, we're at the church, he said, but I'm not so worried. We see this thing, we see the disability. The Mary too, who told you you were able to do that, that's the only thing. They weren't ready to listen, they were there trying to catch him something. And Jesus answered, it wasn't a statement, I had to get asked a question to him. Jesus could have said, you know, blah, 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 whatever. But Jesus, he asked one question and said, remember when he was a young boy, he went in the temple and he was teaching all the people on the main. That is not what it was with him. The mother and brother came and said, what are you doing? And he was saying, I'm doing the presence of the Bible. You know, it's wrong. He'd already calculated on the answer as he was doing it in the temple. Later, Jesus. So we can do that and say, all the authority in heaven are as excluding to me. And the authority, you know, the authority is there, it's from birth. And then we should, even from birth. And Jesus, first of all, God, he asked this question. And for them, and the first of all, they said, I don't know. Did his authority come from God, or was it only from other people? Okay. And then the Pharisees, the system, they kind of had some difference. And if you get together with the priests and the Jewish leaders, come to that piece of question. Okay. They have this discussion that he was got a good answer. John, that was the one from John. And he was that. Why didn't you believe in me? Okay, so it's different. I'm going to say, if a guy who gave John the authority to baptize, I can say that John the Baptist was sent from someone else. We're afraid of people, and they will believe, and they believe that John was a prophet. Okay, so it's kind of stuck there, and I had to answer that question. His authority would say it was different than that. Do you remember Elizabeth, when she was pregnant with him, Mary came to see her and the father asked a question, and then he was unable to speak again until the baby was born. I remember that story. The authority was obvious up and down. John goes to the coming of the moon, and here a pillar goes for the coming of the Christ. And the son said, he must enter. You didn't even notice about this. What was their concern and their reaction of the people? I'm not really sure how to answer that, but they didn't get negative attention. Well, their concern really was about God. How God was looking at our answers rather than trying to please God. They were concerned about how the people or their books feel. You know, how can people look at us? You know, people look at because they're worried, or too worried that people are going to say that it's a prayer. Is it the way that it makes us look, or the way that we make us look? Spirit of God, for the honor and the worship, or do we care more about how people think about us? You know, what happens when people say something about me that's not true? Or am I not a spirit? It doesn't happen that way. You can do what you want to do. You can believe them, or you can believe them. I don't make it guilty for because of the way that they think about me. Okay. I'm going to believe someone else over me. You have that right to do that. You know, I don't think they're saying anything, but I know it's true. Sometimes we're looking for a way to hurt other people instead of hurting people. So we have to think to ourselves when people come up to us with God or whatever. We need to make an example of the way people see us or the way that God sees us. this is, for the intention and the word of God and what other people have done. Just to be the one. My answer should always be the Bible. It's a problem. Father God, I am. And that was, nobody should have done that, there's an, there was one that, the father's girl and the aunt with the bird. Oh, good, you're able to answer. Jesus was good. When the aunt said one something. And then when it went down, they had it right on the phone. He was suffering, really. I tell you, I still like doing prostitute, and during the beginning of the year, before you. And the first time, the first he might have said, no, I'm going to do the work of that, but then he did it in the end. And my kids, if I were to expect it, it was a good thing. First, I said, now we don't have to do anything. But the religious leader, he was like, yes, we will do the work of God, but then they don't do it. So we need to be very careful. Because I do want to remember the church. That you will, you must stay in the sun and love God. The other people who said they were religious, people, what about church? Whether they don't know or can't. And then you're a couple. And then the outward things. That you don't know, there's an inward following that they're doing as well. So I'm thinking, people, I look out. They're doing nothing for the church. They're doing nothing for Christ. And I think something. They look really good on the outside, but they're going to do the bad on them and they do it. So now it's about, you know, putting the same experiment when they change them in the first place. There's a positive way of, you know, staying in place for the church. And, you know, once Jesus approved of our prayers, remember that they received it there. They said, hey, where's the money for the old recording of you? They said, no. But this one that you three brought to them, he was designing to serve God, do the work of God, lose it to Jesus. It's something we need to examine on and say, he's serving God on. You know, it's not for me to come up with, you go do this, you go do that. But no, but I'm not God. You guys know, you know your faith, you feel the risk, and see, you want to start with friend. Yeah, of course I'm a friend. He's the one who saved me. With that friends, I have no friends. Jesus was saved me because of his perfect. I shouldn't think of the God on the cross. I'm going to believe in him, believe in his work on the cross. He did it for me instead of, I read that horrible sermon that he saved me because of his goodness, and I'm thankful for him. And I stay very close to his work with the God, because of the same thing. And people around there don't want to say, oh, I want to thank the Lord. Thank you.